I wish to direct my question to the former president. Mr. President, good afternoon. Good afternoon, Mr. President. First of all, I wish to acknowledge your courage in taking full responsibility, full legal responsibility to all the victims of war on drugs, both legal and illegal, as you have mentioned, Mr. President.
Hindi ko nakontrolado kasi, ma'am.
Mr. President, I wish to manifest that it is my humble opinion that one will not take legal responsibility unless there is no willingness as well to admit being behind all the killing incidents that transpired during the war on drugs. It is therefore the humble submission of this representation, Mr. Chair, that with that statement coming from the former president, he acknowledges that all the killing incidents during the war on drugs spring from his order to kill drug personalities. That is a manifestation, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, I understand that the resource speaker, the former president, is a lawyer. Mr. President, may I request that you educate the Filipino people, and I am certain that you understand what conspiracy theory is all about. Please educate us, Mr. President.
I may have some lapses already, but I will give you the definition of a conspiracy to commit a crime when two or more persons decide or discuss to commit a crime and actually do it, more or less ganon ang takbo ng ano.
Thank you, Mr. President. And you will agree with me, Mr. President, that under the conspiracy theory, mayroon pong tatlong klase ng principal. One is principal by inducement. Two is principal by indispensable cooperation. And three, principal by direct participation. Being a long-time prosecutor, Mr. President, can you please enlighten us on this?
Well, one is yung induce. It could be an inducement, could be money, usually, or inducement by a woman to a man to kill her husband, so that they can live forever, happily, ever after. Or a group of persons, sindikato, lahat, what is illegal, gambling, smuggling, these are the conspirators of crime.
So you have explained, Mr. President, principal by inducement. It could be money, it could be an order by a person who have influence over another.
Inducement.
How about principal by direct participation, Mr. President?
You actually agree with one another to commit the crime and you participate.
Thank you. And how about principal by indispensable cooperation?
Well, in the sense that, for example, if there is no way of traveling from one place to another and you are the only person who can provide the transportation, a vehicle, and that would be indispensable cooperation. without the vehicle, you cannot commit the crime.
Thank you, Mr. President, for enlightening us. Going back to your statement that you are taking full legal responsibility to all the victims of war on drugs, both legal and illegal. It is my humble submission, Mr. Chair, that the former president can be considered liable for all these crimes under the theory of conspiracy by being a principal by inducement. I wish to manifest, Mr. Chair, that without the order, without the reward, these police operatives should not have resulted to killing a huge number of victims of war on drugs.
Beg to disagree with your premise, ma'am.
I understand, Mr. President, but that is a manifestation.
Yes, but you
Thank
know,
you,
a police
President.
Is supposed to do his duty. He goes to school for 2 years. He receives instructions to how to go about his duty. And we have to give the presumption of regularity. That's a principle of law.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Pag every time na may ginawa kayo, in your favor is a principle of regularity.
Presumption of regularity
of duty.
Of performance of official duty, Mr. President. Thank you for your enlightenment. Mr. President, I wish to ask, with all due respect, considering your statement of taking full legal responsibility, both to legal and illegal activities, can I equate this statement of yours to an extrajudicial confession of guilt?
Well, in a sense, yes. Wala na akong magawa eh.
Are you saying yes, Mr. President?
Yes, because I ordered the campaign against the drug syndicates. At kung anong ginawa nila, whether illegal or not, it was ako ang nag-utos. In that sense, I take that responsibility of their actions. Wala akong magawa eh. Commander ako, nag-utos ako. Puntahan ninyo yan. Eh, just like a commander, or not a military, police, iutosan mo. Pag may nangyari dyan, magkabulyaso, whether right or wrong, iyo yan. Iyo talaga yan. Kung hindi ka naman bobo na mayor, eh, hindi mo iwanan yung tao na inutosan mo. Unless yung pumunta doon, inutosan mo mag-operate ng illegal gambling or druga, tapos nag-rape, kung anong ginagawa na kabalastugan, ako na mismo ang papatay, hindi na kailangan na hintayin mo pa.
Mr. President, earlier, you conform to my statement that I can equate your statement of taking full legal responsibility as an extrajudicial confession of guilt. You said yes to that.
Yeah, indeed.
No, I'm just reiterating the question, Mr. President.
It's not about guilt or a wrong. What I'm saying is that yung lahat ng inutosan ko yung war against drugs, o yung isang platoon dyan o isang batalyon, kung ano yung ginagawa nila, I take full responsibility for that.
Mr. President, you are surrounded by, I believe, 4 lawyers.
Hindi ko na kailangan, and ma'am.
Because you are a lawyer yourself.
I can take care of myself.
And of course, you understand the elements of an extrajudicial confession.
Yes.
You confirm that you are of sound mind.
Not only that, body.
Yes.
As well.
You confirm that your statement is voluntary.
Yes.
And of course, you confirm that you understand the consequences of your extrajudicial confession.
Hindi naman alam, hindi naman ito korte. So
I understand, Mr. President. That's why we call it extra judicial confession.
It is not a confession, it is a statement coming from the mouth of a mayor or a president at that time. It is not a confession. You are characterizing the word. Mali, ma'am.
The only one
do not characterize that as a wrong.
Mr. President,
palisihan.
The only one that is missing among these elements is that it should be in writing.
What?
And my question will you be willing to translate into writing the statement that you earlier said?
Hindi na nga ako marunong yung pirma ko noon, hindi na nga pirma ko ngayon.
But of course, you have a lawyers to help and assist you. Prepare this written document.
Hindi ko na kailangan yan. Babayad ko pa writing dito na ngayon. It's documented by the records here. Magtanong na kayo ng magtanong. Ano? Anong gusto mong tanongin? Criminal?
Mr. President, I wish to proceed to my next question. Do you know Laod firing range?
Do you know?
Alam niyo po ba yung Laod firing range?
So hindi do you know?
Nalalaman niyo po ba kung ano o saan yung Laod firing range?
Doon ako nagpa-practice mo magbaril para pumatay ng tao.
Thank you. Nagpa-practice po kayong bumaril para pumatay ng tao. And alam nyo din po ba yung Laod Quarry?
Hindi ko na negosyo yan, ma'am. Yung firing range.
But at least you are aware that Laod firing range is situated in the Laod Quarry, within the premises and compound of Laod Quarry.
Siguro.
Tama
within
po ba yun?
The premises of a quarry, there is a firing range.
That do you confirm that, Mr. President?
That should be the question.
Do you know Ben Laod?
Yes, I think so.
Who is Ben Laod?
Si policeman.
He's a policeman.
He owns the land.
He owns the land.
Where the firing range is located.
And do you remember, Mr. President, that the CHR, during the time of the former chairman, Laila De Lima, investigated and inspected this Laod Quarry, where they were able to discover human bones? Are you aware of that?
Sino ma? Who investigated?
Panahon po ni Chairman Laila De Lima sa Commission on Human Rights.
Sorry, I do not know her.
Nag-imbestiga po ang CHR tungkol sa extrajudicial killing kung saan nakadiskubre po ang taga-CHR na mga buto ng katawan ng tao. Kayo po ba ay aware dito?
I am aware of only one bone. Dala-dala ni... Sino yung sinabi mo?
CHR former chairwoman, Laila De Lima.
It's there. Hindi, isa lang po.
And you are aware also that the former DOJ Secretary, Vitaliano Aguirre, represented Ben Laod in the investigation of the extrajudicial killing.
What do I know about the investigation?
Or if you are aware, Aguirre? Mr. President.
Yes, Aguirre is my...
Are you associated? Of course, you are associated to Vitaliano Aguirre as a matter of fact.
He's my...
contemporary.
Sa eskwelahan, no?
And during your time, you appointed him even as the DOJ Secretary. Tama po ba?
Yes. Because bright.
During that time, Mr. President, you were the mayor. Tama po? Mayor of Davao City.
I cannot appoint a secretary. Hindi ako, mayor lang ako po. So, it has to be...
Now, let me rephrase my question, Mr. President.
Somebody else's job, not mine.
During the time when these extrajudicial killings happened, you were the mayor? Tama po ba yun?
Well, not only during my time as mayor.
Was there any point in time, Mr. President, na pinaimbestigahan niyo po itong mga buto ng tao na nakita sa Laud Quarry?
Dala nga ni senior? Si hindi yung nag-imbestiga doon?
The CHR, Mr. President.
Oh, si CHR.
Kayo po ba'y nagpa-imbestiga? Even during your time as mayor or during your time as president, pinaimbestigahan niyo po ba itong mga buto na nakita sa Laud Quarry?
Bakit ako mag-imbestiga ng mga buto dyan na maraming buto ng tao na...
So you did not initiate any investigation?
Of course.
Mr. President, I will proceed to the next question. On December 31, 2004... nag-conduct po ng raid ang PIDEA 11, headed by Superintendent Wilkins Villanueva, joined by some operatives of PIDEA Manila, National Headquarter. Anim po yung Chinese na napatay. But in addition to this Chinese, a certain SPO4, Val Carillo, apprehended Alan C., along with 10 other companions. Based on the affidavit of Mr. Las Cañas, Mr. President, you ordered the killing of Mr. Alan C. along with the 10 other companions.
That is not true. That is the job of the police. Hindi ko trabaho magpatay, ma'am.
There are two important observations in his affidavit, Mr. President. Ang sabi po niya dito, si Alan C. ay nag-offer ng 200 million for the release of the two chemists and another 100 million for the remaining 8 personalities. But when he tried to seek your permission, you refused and you even said, madami kayong intel funds.
Totoo yan. Kung bribery siguro yan. Hindi ko, never in my...
Are you confirming, Mr. President, that during this time, Las Cañas and Sunny Buenaventura sought your permission whether to release Alan C. and the 10 others in exchange of the 200 million plus 100 million?
Siyado maraking pera yan, man. Totoo yan.
You are denying it, Mr. President.
Of course.
But do you confirm that when you refused this offer, you even told Sunny Buenaventura and Arturo Las Cañas that you have ample intel funds, so you don't need those bribes, if you call it bribe?
I do not remember making a statement like that. But money for operations against crime, malaki ang funding ng Davao City.
Another important observation, Mr. President, these 11 personalities were asked as to the whereabouts of their passport. Alan C. said that his passport was taken by the operatives, while the 10 others, ang sabi po nila, hawak ng employer nila. And the employer was named as Michael Young. What can you say about this?
Nothing to do with it. Wala akong pakialam dyan. Hindi ako nakikialam ng mga passport.
Mr. President, to conclude the question about this Dumoy raid. This is the raid of the PIDEA which happened in Davao Shabu Laboratory on December 31, 2004 where 6 Chinese personalities were killed during the raid and the 11 others were brought to Laud Quarry where they were summarily executed and buried upon your order according to the testimony of Arturo Las Cañas.
Do not believe Arturo Las Cañas.
Let me proceed
Binubula
to the
ka lang niya.
Next question, Mr. President. In 1993, Mr. President, binomba po itong St. Peter's Cathedral in Davao City where 7 died. Naalala niyo po ba ito? And according
Point
to Arturo Las Cañas,
Mr. Chair, point of order.
What was the
I would like to find out
excuse me,
if Attorney Delgra is coaching the President because she has been whispering in the ears of the former President. What to find out?
Attorney Delgra, please refrain from coaching. The President is able to answer all these questions being asked of him.
Advising me.
And
about
you are only
rights.
Limited to advising the
legal
your client
rights.
With his rights. Nothing more, nothing less.
He's
I hope you follow the rule, Attorney Delgra. Please proceed.
He does not have to coach me. I know how to answer.
Mr. Chair? 1993, binomba po ang St. Peter's Cathedral, Davao City, where 7 died. Nalala niyo po ba ito, Mr. President?
Yung simbahan, ma'am?
Opo, St. Peter's Cathedral in Davao
yes,
City.
Ma'am.
At sangayon po kay Arturo Las Cañas, kayo ay galit na galit sa pangyayaring ito.
Sinong hindi magalit, ma'am?
At dahil po sa inyong mahigpit na galit, ay inorderan nyo po itong sina Las Cañas na bombahin ang mga moske kasama po ang Camamara Mosque at Bancorehan Mosque. What can you say about this?
It's crazy, ma'am. Do you know that my mother is a Muslim? That's an idiot statement.
In other words, you are denying.
Of course.
Mr. President, let me proceed to Jun Pala. Sino po si Jun Pala?
Well, he was a broadcaster.
He is a broadcaster who used to criticize you during his programs. Tama po ba?
Everybody, pati ako, tama yan. Trabaho niya yan.
And according to the testimony of Arturo Las Cañas, you ordered the killing of Jun Pala.
Niwala kay Las Cañas. Lahat na nandong participation ng crime niya, kanya. There's a pattern, you know. Look at the pattern of the crimes. Kanya lahat ng ano. Do you believe that as a policeman? Would I?
Kanina po, Mr. President, I started my interpellation with acknowledging your courage in taking full legal responsibility to all the victims of war on drugs, and you said both legal and illegal. The reasons why I ask about Laod Quarry, where human bones were found, the reason why I ask about the Dumoy raid, where 11 Chinese personalities were summarily brought and killed to Laod Quarry. The reason about why I ask about the mosque bombing and the killing of Jun Pala is I wanted to substantiate the courage that I saw on you when you initially expressed taking full legal responsibility to all the victims of war on drugs, both legal and illegal, according to you.
You are substantiate?
Yes, Mr. President.
Where's your proof?
Mr. President, I'm anchoring my questions about the separate incidents from your initial statement that you are taking full legal responsibility
yes.
to all the victims of war on drugs. You said both legal and illegal.
Yes.
Mr. President, you are a long-time prosecutor, correct? And of course, it is very fundamental upon us, all lawyers, the requirements of due process.
We are zeroing in on a particular individual now.
Due process is the law which hears before it condemns. Due process is the law which requires notice and hearing.
If you say so.
Mr. President, I hope that we will be reminded that by due process, the end does not justify the means. Kanina po, tinanong din po kayo ni Honorable Brosas about the number of the victims of war on drugs. Tinanong po kayo about statistics and you lamented na hindi nyo po alam or dala yung records. Now, I want to share to the public the statistics of the victims of war on drugs. Mr. President, this is from PIDEA. I think this is a consolidated effort of Karapatan, Global Witness, National Union of Journalists of the Philippines, the Supreme Court, RAPLR, and the Philippine Drug and Enforcement Agency. We have 6,252 individuals in police anti-drug operations as of May 2022. 27,000 to 30,000 individuals, including those killed vigilant style. 427 activists, human rights defenders, grassroots organizers as of December 2021. Land and environment defenders as of December 2020, 166. Journalists, media workers, as of April 2022, 23 victims. Judges, lawyers, prosecutors, as of December 2021, 66 victims. And mayors, vice mayors, as of December 2021, 28 victims, Mr. President. Mr. President, my question is, when you implement war on drugs, did you strictly comply with the requirement of due process?
Yes.
Mr. Chair, I will wrap up. Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. Chair, it is my humble submission that contrary to the answer of the former president, I humbly believe that the former president and his war on drugs never complied with the requirements of due process. The statistics show, Mr. President, the huge number of victims of war on drugs. If my memory serves me right, during the time of Aquino administration, there are like around 200. And during the present administration, there are around like 200 victims as well of war on drugs. Given this statistics, Mr. Chair, this is almost or around 31,000 victims of war on drugs. If indeed they follow the requirement of due process, wala po dapat ganito karaming patay. At ang dapat maraming kaso na pending in court. I hope all of us will be reminded by the fundamental law that no person should be deprived of life, liberty, and property without due process of law. By Mr. President's own admission of his accountability, both to legal and illegal actions of the police, it is the humble submission of this representation, Mr. Chair, that the Quadcom is ready to make a recommendation for the filing of the necessary action in court. That is a violation of the law, RA 9851, Act defining and penalizing crimes against international humanitarian law, or at the very least, the murder cases as defined under the revised penal code. To finally conclude, Mr. Chair, last series of questions to Mr. President, again to substantiate the courage that he was able to show during the initial part of this hearing. Mr. President, in the past hearing of Quadcom, may tatlo pong Chinese drug lords na napatay sa Davao Penal Colony. Are you willing to take accountability and responsibility also for this?
Wala na ako niyan, ma'am. Nandito na ako sa Maynila.
So, you are saying no?
Oh, well, kung gusto mo isali yan, idagdag mo na, okay lang.
How about the death of General Barayuga, the PSCSO Secretary, are you willing to take full legal responsibility for this?
I do not kill generals.
The death of Mayor Aldong Parohinog and the 15 others in Osamis City, are you taking full responsibility on this?
Hindi ako nagpapatay ng mga mayor, ma'am.
The death of Mayor Espinosa of Albuera Leyte, are you taking full responsibility on this?
Hindi, ma'am. That is my birthplace.
The death of Tony Halili in Tanawan City.
Malayo yan siya sa akin, ma'am.
The death of Mayor Perez of Los Baños.
Lalo na.
Ibalik ko po dun sa una niyong sinabi, if you are denying all this, alin po yung tinutukoy niyo when you said you are taking full legal responsibility to all the victims of war on drugs, both legal and illegal?
Yes. Kasi order po kasi yung, that was my campaign against drug. Na yung, alam mo, maraming istasyon, maraming pulis. Kung nagkaletse-letse doon, hindi ka maghugas ng kamay. Dapat sabihin mo, akin dyan, kasi of course, nagkamali sila. Now, if there is an appropriate action na gusto ninyong ilabas, then file the case in court. Wala nang pigil. Matagal na yan yung sabi extrajudicial killing. I am challenging anybody or everybody who makes the accusation, whether it is really true or not, it may be true, file the case in court because may korte tayo. And even if I would admit na totoo yan, you have to go to court because I will make the admission there again.
Are you saying, Mr. President, that when you go to court, you're willing to admit also your accountability for all the deaths during the war on drugs?
Ay, of course, may abogado man ako, ma'am. Kung ano sabihin ng abogado, susunod ako.
I hope that everything that you said before the quad can be reduced in writing so that truly we can believe that you're taking full legal responsibility to all the victims of war on drugs, both legal and illegal, because as lawyers, we believe that by extrajudicial confession, we have to put that in writing, Mr. President.
Totoo yan, ma'am. I ordered the campaign against drugs. Hindi ako it's a policy of government or of the president. Hindi ako maghugas ng kamay. Hindi ako magsabi hindi kasi yung department niya. Hindi, akin yun.
Mr. President, last question. If one of these days the ICC will come, will you voluntarily submit yourself?
Sipain ko pa sila, ma'am.
But you said a while ago that if somebody will sponsor your fare to the ICC, you will voluntarily submit yourself to their investigation and jurisdiction.
Yes. Pero kung sila magpunta dito, sipain ko.
But will you confirm that you are willing to submit voluntarily yourself to ICC?
Punta ko doon, sipain ko rin sila. Same.
I have nothing further, Mr. Chair. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Congresswoman Luistro. The next